Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, joining us here and virtually via live streaming. I'm Marty Ballow. I'm the president of the Sarah Siddons Society. We are very grateful for your support of our mission to fund theater artist scholarships at four Chicago area universities, to distribute professional development grants to emerging theater artists, and offer complimentary education programs by the Sarah Siddons Artistic Council. Thank you to our sponsors of tonight's show. We couldn't do it without you. If you're not a member, please go to our website and join. You can learn about our upcoming activities. Any volunteer organization like the Sarah Siddons Society is only as strong as those who volunteer their time. I would like our board members in the audience to stand and be recognized. On a personal note, in addition to our entire talented cast, I would especially like to thank our dedicated director for this evening, Carla Gordon. And our amazing music director, Becky Menzi. Becky was with us at the very first Swell Soirée in 2019. So we're so glad to have you back. Tonight, our theme celebrates the city's great musical past. But we also embrace the future with our four student performers who will be joining the seasoned pros on stage. Speaking of the past, right now, I'm gonna close my eyes, think about being 30 years younger, a lot thinner, with a full head of hair, and I'm heading to the Gentry on Rush Street, where I first heard the incredibly talented Becky Menzi. Becky, please take me and our audience back to those wonderful days.
I worked at the 19 years at the Gentry of Chicago. A fabulous, did I say fabulous, entertainment room that was the premier Chicago entertainment gay club. And boy, did I learn how to entertain there. You have to know hundreds of songs. New York, New York, Cabaret, Over the Rainbow. And since I hosted their Sunday open mics, I played close to 1,000 Sundays of singers. What good is sitting alone in your room? Come hear the music play. Life is a cabaret, old chum. Come to the cabaret. Put down the knitting, the book, and the broom. It's time for a holiday. Life is a cabaret, old chum. Come to the cabaret. Come taste the wine. Come hear the band. Come blow your horn, start celebrating. Right this way, your table's waiting. What good's permitting some prophet of doom to wipe every smile away? Life is a cabaret, old chum. Come to the cabaret. Oh, I made some of my best friends at that club. And then I got to meet all sorts of new people. I would meet the new young buck who would grab me and say, hey, my mom's coming to visit and I'm gonna bring her here to see you. I would go, that'll be great. My name is Jamie. It's gonna be great, Jamie. He just wanted me to know his name. He wanted his mom to know he had a community. Sometimes you wanna go where everybody knows your name. And they're always glad you came. You want to be where you can see. Our problems are all the same. You want to go where everybody knows your name. While Gentry was a party, one of my most memorable memories was on 9/11, because Tom and I were slated to entertain that night. And it was 9/11. So I called David Edwards, who was the owner of Gentry, and I said, "Are we even open tonight?" And he answered, "Absolutely. I don't care if there are four people in the club. They need someone to be with, and that's going to be you." So Tom and I entertained, we sang, and the people there, we just ended up talking for most of the night. I loved the Gentry. I stayed there until the not-so-pretty last day. It had just been so important to me that I couldn't leave. I was actually 6 days short of 19 years. I think of Gentry to this very day. I remember how I'd look at folks and say, "What good is sitting alone in your room? Come hear the music play. Life is a cabaret, old chum, and I love a cabaret. And as for me, what I learned way back then in Gentry, now it seems so elementary. Start by admitting from cradle to tomb, it isn't that long a stay. Life is a cabaret, old chum, only a cabaret, old chum. And I loved that cabaret."
We're glad you're here. We're glad that you're going to join us as we bring back the heyday of Chicago nightclubs. We hope that you can turn your thoughts back to those days of sitting in those upholstered booths, drinking elegant cocktails, having a fancy dinner. Our city boasts great clubs, Mr. Kelly's, the Savoy on the South Side, Chez Paree, and we're going to talk about a lot more. So tonight, feel free, shrug off your mink stole. Come on, ladies. Gentlemen, put down your fedoras, and we're going to go clubbing. So, I want to go clubbing with the great Sophie Tucker. So I'm going to put on my Sophie Tucker hat. Sophie performed at the Green Mill, which is actually the only club we will be saluting tonight that is actually still an operating club. Mm-hmm. Now, my parents saw her at the Chez Paree, and they couldn't stop talking about the one and only Sophie Tucker. Sheik's Neckers and Jelly Beans, lend me your ears. So you think you've been petted? Don't be silly, forget it. Debs, flappers, and baby vamps, they bore me to tears. What do they know concerning love? Come to me with your burning love. I'm the last of the red hot mamas,
They've all cooled down but me. I'm not one who'll only neck 'em. I'm a mama who loves to wreck 'em. I can make 'em sizzle, fry and frizzle. And if you wanna know the truth, I can warm the cold ones, give the old ones back their flaming youth. I was born in the hot Bahamas. Right now I'm in my loving prime. Away up in Alaska where the natives freeze. An Eskimo left my hut in his BVDs. I'm the last of the red hot mamas, getting hotter all the time. This is when Sophie would walk around and show off her clothes and her hats. You petters in raccoon coats, just call on me. If you're cold, let me warm you. My kiss will chloroform you. Don't worry, I know my oats. I guarantee you can be sure that when I pet, yeah, I ruin the man I pet. 'Cause I'm the last of the red hot mamas. They've all cooled down but me. I'm not one who'll only neck 'em. Yeah, I'm a mama who's gonna wreck 'em. I can make 'em sizzle, fry, and frizzle. If you wanna know the truth, I can warm the cold ones, give all the old ones back their flaming youth. I was born in the hot Bahamas. I'm in my prime. Those flappers pet and don't know what it's all about. When I kiss men, they think they've had their tonsils out. I'm the last of the red hot mamas, getting hotter all the time. I'm getting hotter all the time. Thank you, and it is my pleasure to introduce my good friend, Mr. David Edelfeld.
Thank you, Carla. Test, test, hello. Test, test, thank you. Thank you, Carla. Privately, Carla told me that I was nearly as handsome as Vic Damone. I think it was meant to be a compliment, but you decide. I do know that regardless of whether he was singing at the Chez Paree or at the Empire Room, that he really seduced the audience. I'm not going to do that. This time we almost made the pieces fit, didn't we? This time we almost made some sense of it, didn't we? This time I had the answer right here in my hand. Then I touched it, and it had turned to sand. Maybe I should have saved those leftover dreams. Funny, but here's that rainy day. That rainy day they told me about, and I laughed at the thought that it might turn out this way. Where is that worn out wish that I threw aside?
after it brought my lover near. Funny how love becomes a cold, rainy day. Funny. That rainy day is here.
Thank you. Thank you, Becky. It is my honor to introduce the magnificent Brianna Johnson to join me on stage from Columbia College.
Things have come to a pretty pass. Our romance is growing flat. For you like this and the other, while I go for this and for that.
Goodness knows what the end will be. How I don't know where I'm at. It looks as if we two will never be one.
Something must be done. 'Cause you say either and I say either. You say neither, and I say neither.
Either.
Either.
Neither.
Neither.
Let's call the whole thing off. I like potato, and you like potato. I like tomato, and you like tomato. Potato.
Potato.
Tomato.
Tomato.
Let's call the whole thing off.
But, oh, if we call the whole thing off, then we must part.
And oh, if we ever part, then that might break my heart.
So if you like pajamas and I like pajamas,
I'll wear pajamas and you wear pajamas.
For we know we need each other, so we better call the calling off off. Let's call the whole thing off.
You know, maybe we should just call this whole thing off. I don't see it working.
I don't either. Maybe it's because of our age difference, or I don't know, because we were raised in different cultures, or because we're attracted to the same men.
Oh. Yeah, that might be it. But there's more. I say laughter and you say laughter. I say after and you say after. After.
Laughter?
After.
After?
Let's call the whole thing off. Well, you say vanilla, and I say vanilla. You sarsaparilla, and I sarsaparilla. Vanilla.
Vanilla.
Okay, chocolate.
Strawberry.
Oh, come on. Let's hold the whole thing off. But oh, if we call the whole thing off, then we must part.
And oh, if we ever part, then that might break my heart.
Mine too. So if you go for oysters and I go for oysters,
I'll order oysters and cancel the oysters.
For we know we need each other, so we better call the calling off. Let's call the whole thing off.
So much. Hi, everyone. Again, my name is Brianna Johnson, and today I will be honoring Barbara Streisand, who performed in Mr. Kelly's Club by singing the song My Coloring Book.
For those who fancy coloring books, as certain people do, here's a new one for you. A most unusual coloring book, the kind you never see. Crayons ready, very well. Begin to walked away. Color them gray. This is the heart that thought we would always be true. Color it.
Now introducing Ron Keaton.
From the sublime to the ridiculous. I'm singing Jeepers Creepers. There's a history to this song. I'll be very brief. Jeepers Creepers was the name of a racehorse. The racehorse was a character in a film, and Louis Armstrong sang the song to the horse because he was the horse's trainer. It was released recorded-wise by Helen O'Connell, who came to Mr. Kelly's quite often. And then there's Mel Torme, who made it a part of his regular routine when he would come to Mr. Kelly's because he considered it lucky to sing the song and then go the next morning to the track Allet Arlington. So, shall we? A one, two, three, go!
Jeepers, creepers, where'd you get those peepers? Jeepers, creepers, how'd you get those eyes? Gosh, all get up, how'd they get so lit up? Gosh, all get up, how'd they get that size? Oh, golly gee, when you turn those heaters on, woe is me. Gotta put my cheaters on. Jeepers, creepers, where'd you get those peepers? Oh, those weepers, how they hypnotize. Where'd you get those eyes, maestro? Golly gee, when you put those heaters on, woe is me, gotta put my cheaters on. Jeepers, creepers, how'd you get those peepers? Oh, those weepers, how they hypnotize. Where'd you get those eyes? Where did you get those eyes?
In experiences like this, we all make new friends. My next one is now a new friend. Her name is Arlene Armstrong.
I guess I'll take the short mic. Sarah Vaughn, AKA Sassy, AKA the Divine One. She recorded her 1957 Live at Mr. Kelly's with Sarah Vaughn and her trio. Star eyes, that to me is what your eyes are. Soft and stars as April skies are. Tell me soon if it adores that loveliness of yours. Star eyes, flashing eyes in which my hopes rise. Let me show you where my heart lies. Let me prove that it adores that loveliness of yours. All my life I felt content to stargaze at the sky. Now I only want to melt the stardust in your eyes. Star eyes, when if ever will my lips know if it's me for whom those eyes glow? Let me soon not be apart. Your eyes will hold my wishing star. Oh, star eyes, how lovely you are. Ladies and gentlemen, Becky Menzies. Felt content to stargaze at the sky. Now I only want to melt the stardust in your eyes. Star eyes, when if ever will my lips know if it's me for whom these eyes glow? Makes no difference where you are. Your eyes will hold my wishing star. Oh, star eyes, how lovely you are. How lovely you are. How lovely you Nat King Cole played at the Blue Room, which was the first integrated city club here in Chicago. And my friend Anna Rosenthal from Northwestern University and I are gonna sing a little song that has a little meaning behind it.
Took a monkey for a ride in the air. The monkey thought that everything was on the square.
The monkey tried to throw the buzzard off of his back, but the monkey grabbed his neck and said, "Hey, listen, Jack.
Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and stay right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top.
What's the use in jiving? Ain't no use in diving. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top."
The buzzard told the monkey, "You are choking me. Release your hold and I will set you free."
The monkey tried to throw the buzzard off of his back and said,
"Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and stay right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top." The buzzard told the monkey, "You are choking me. Release your hold and I will set you free."
The monkey took the buzzard right down the eye and said, "Dude, come on, really?
Straighten up
and fly right. Straighten up and stay right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Fly right."
I am getting the immense privilege to honor a childhood hero and all-time favorite of mine, Judy Garland. She sang the song that I'm going to be singing at Chez Paree. And this is "The Man That Got Away" by Ira Gershwin and Harold Arlen. I got there, it took a second.
"
the stars have lost their glitter, the winds grow colder, and suddenly you're older, and all because of the man that got away. No more his eager call, the writing's on the wall, the dreams you dreamed have all gone astray. Has run off and undone you. The great beginning has seen its final inning. Don't know what happened. It's all a crazy game.
Privilege of announcing David Muehlmans.
Good evening. Tonight I'm celebrating we'll figure it out. In Chicago, right now, you can book a tour of the clubs where this luminous star worked over the years. Here in Chicago, you can go take a class at the Impersonators Club. The Blue-Eyed Boy from Hoboken, Frank Sinatra. Opening act at the Sherman House, headliner with the Dorseys at the Palmer House. Notorious stories from the Green Mill. I'd like to honor him this evening, along with hundreds of other performers who've recorded this song. Thank you.
play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, darling, kiss me. Fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. In other words, I love you. Fly me to the moon and let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, darling, kiss and kiss and kiss me. Fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. Oh, in other words, in other words.
Thank you.
Thank you. As a member of a certain age, I've said a few things about the younger generation I'm really not proud of, especially after seeing these young singers tonight. I take it all back. The American Songbook is in wonderful hands. Amazing. I have the great pleasure tonight of singing a little duet with one of these fine young musicians. Won't you put your hands together and welcome to the stage, Eric Amundson. Shine like you've had too much wine, that's amore.
Bells will ring, ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling, and you'll sing Vita Bella. Hearts will play, tippy-tippy-tay, tippy-tippy-tay, like a gay tarantella.
You've got it.
When the stars make you drool in your pasta frizzle, that's amore. When you dance down the street with a cloud at your feet, you're in love.
When you walk in a dream, but you know you're not dreaming, signore. Scusa me, but you see, back in old Napoli, that's amore.
Now, Eric, I bet you sing like this, especially when you're in love. Are you in love?
Of course I am.
Me too, I love being in love.
So do I. And I bet you all do too.
And do you like to sing too?
When the moon hits your eye like a
big pizza pie, that's amore. When the world sees you shine like you've had too much wine, that's amore.
We'll take it from here.
Bells will ring, ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling, and you'll say, Vita Bella.
Life is beautiful.
Hearts will play, tippy-tippy-tay, tippy-tippy-tay, like a gay tarantella.
Lucky fella.
When the stars make you drool, just like pasta fazool, that's amore. When you dance down the street with a cloud at your feet, you're in love. When you walk in a dream, but you know you're not dreaming, signore.
Scusa me, but you see, back in old Napoli,
that's amore. Tonight, I get to pay homage to the late, great Tony Bennett, who performed at our very own late and very great Chez Paree with this little tune, Rags to Riches. I know I'd go from rags to riches if you would only say you care. And though my pocket may be empty, I'd be a millionaire. My clothes may still be torn and tattered, but in my heart I'd be a king. Your love is all that ever matters. It's everything. So open your arms and I'll open the door to every treasure that I'm looking for. Oh, hold me and kiss me and tell me you're mine evermore. Must I forever be a beggar whose golden dreams will not come true? Or will I go from rags to riches? My fate is up to you. Whose golden dreams will not come true. Oh no, or will I go from rags to riches? My fate is up to you. Thank you. Thank you very much, folks. One more time for Becky. Oh my gosh. Crazy. It is, of course, my immense honor to acknowledge our next performer coming up, the illustrious Zoe Sotiris.
I've never been called illustrious before. That was very nice. I'm very excited to be honoring the incredible Ella Fitzgerald, the icon. She sang How Long Has This Been Going On by George and Ira Gershwin at the Chez Paree, at the Sunset Cafe, and at many other places. So thank you very much. Neath the stars at bazaars, often I've had to caress men. $5 or $10 then I'd collect from all those yes men. Don't be sad, I must add that they meant no more than chessmen. Darling, can't you see? 'Twas for charity. Though these lips have made slips, it was never really serious. Never thought I'd be brought to a state that's so delirious. I could cry salty tears. Where have I been?
You got applause.
I know.
What's going on with you?
Well, Becky, it's like this.
This.
I hear singing and there's no one there.
Sometimes that's good.
I smell blossoms and the trees are bare. All day long I seem to walk on air. I wonder why I keep talking. tossing in my sleep at night.
Xanax.
And what's more, I've lost my appetite. Stars that used to twinkle in the skies are twinkling in my eyes. I wonder why. Why, Becky?
You don't need analyzing. It is not so surprising that you feel very strange. Very strange, but nice. Your heart goes pitter-patter. I know just what's the matter, because I've been there once or twice.
Twice?
A lot of times. Put your head on my shoulder. You need someone who's bolder. We need to rewrite that line.
Yeah.
Okay. A rub down with a velvet glove. There is nothing you can take to relieve that pleasant ache. You're not sick, well, you're sick, but you're just in love.
I hear singing and there's no one there. I smell blossoms and the trees are bare. All day long I seem to walk on air. I wonder why.
Because I've been there.
I wonder why.
I've been there once or twice.
Becky Menzie, everyone!
And Zoe Adams.
Up next, I am so excited to welcome Ron Keaton back to the stage along with the amazing Carla Gordon. Here we go.
I paid her to say amazing. I want to talk about Harry Chapin. Harry Chapin, it was considered a writer in folk, but actually he graced Mr. Kelly's. I was very surprised to see that he graced Mr. Kelly's. If you know cabaret, and I presume that you're here because you love cabaret, cabaret is so much about story and story songs. And Harry wrote just the best story songs that ever were, and we're going to do one of them for you.
It was an early morning barroom, and the place just opened up, and a little man come in so fast and started at his cups. Now the broad who served the whiskey, she was a big old friendly girl, and she tried to fight her empty nights by smiling at the world. And she said,
"Hey, it's been a while, bub, since you've been around. Where the hell you been hiding? And why you look so down?"
But the little man just sat there like he'd never heard a sound. The waitress, she gave out a cough, and acting not the least put off, she spoke once again. She said,
"Look, I don't want to bother you. Consider it understood. And I know I ain't no beauty queen, but I sure can listen good."
And the little man put his drink in his hand and he took it to his lips. He took a couple of sips and he told the waitress this story. I am the midnight watchman down at Miller's Tool and Die. I watch the metal rusting, I watch the time go by. A week ago at the diner, I stopped to get a bite. And this here lovely lady, she sat two seats from my right. And Lord, 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 she was all right. She was so damn beautiful, she could warm a winter frost. But she was long past lonely, well nigh on to lost. Now I'm not much of a mover or a pick-em-up easy guy, but I decided to glide on over and give her one good try. And Lord, 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 she was worth a try. Tongue-tied like a schoolboy, I stammered out some words. But it really did not matter much, for I don't think she heard. She just looked clear on through me to a space back in my head. It shamed me into silence as quietly she said,
if you want me to come with you, that's all right with me, 'cause I know I'm going nowhere, and anywhere's a better place to be.
I drove her to my boarding house and took her up to my room. I went to turn on the only light to brighten up the gloom. But she said,
please leave the light on, I don't mind the dark.
And as her clothes tumbled all around her, I could hear my heart. Moonlight shone upon her as she lay back in my bed. It was the kind of scene I only had imagined in my head. I just could not believe it, to think she was real. And as I tried to tell her, she said,
shh, I know just how you feel. And if you want to stay here with me, that's all right with me, 'cause I know I'm going nowhere, anywhere's a better place to be.
Morning came so swiftly as I held her in my arms, and she slept like a baby, snug and safe from harm. I did not want to share her with the world or break the mood. So before she woke, I went out and got us both some food. I come back with my paper bag to find that she was gone. She'd left a 6-word letter saying,
it's time that I moved on.
Waitress took her bar rack and she wiped it across her eyes. And as she spoke, her voice came out as something like a sigh. She said,
I wish that I was beautiful, or you were halfway blind. I wish I weren't so goddamn fat. I wish that you were mine, and I wish that you'd come with me when I leave for home, 'cause we both know all about loneliness and living all alone.
And the little man looked at the empty glass in his hand. He smiled a crooked grin, said, I guess I'm out of gin. And I know we both have been so lonely. And if you want me to come with you, then that's all right with me. I know we're going nowhere,
and anywhere's a better place to be. Well, it's thank you time. So, gosh, so many people to thank. Pianoforte, this is my second time directing for Marty at Pianoforte. They are so great. They do everything they promise, and they're gracious, and they make us feel right at home. So thank you, Pianoforte. And our technical director, Rachel. And I got to talk about Marty. Marty's our producer, and no matter what kind of stuff hits the fan, Marty is cool. Marty keeps the moving parts moving. So I would like to announce officially that I am nominating Marty Ballow for President of the United States. Thank you so much for clubbing with us. Did you feel good going back into the past and going into Mr. Kelly's and all those places? Because we hope it was as joyful for you as it was for us. We had a great time. I'd like to call up our talented cast. We have Eric Amundsen. Amundsen, he pronounces it Amundsen. My buddy Arlene Armstrong. David Edelfelt. Brianna Johnson. Ron Keaton. David Mullemans. Anna Rosenthal. Zoe Sosteres. And of course, the Becky Menzie Philharmonic Orchestra. Doctor?
Did anybody say our director, Carla Gordon?
You take Manhattan, you can keep that, and give me Chicago any day.
LA may be hot, ain't got what we got. Give me Chicago any day.
Give me the homegrown people who say what they mean. Give me the lake, the river, so fabulous and green.
Give me the best tall buildings the world has ever
ever seen. We take the blue out of the sky, so there's nothing left for Cleveland. Don't wanna see more of old Baltimore. Give me Chicago any day. I won't get lost in the streets of Boston. Give me Chicago any day.
Just give me Michigan Avenue. Any time of year, leave and you'll wish again. And haven't you that you were living here? We got Studs Terkel, got Wiener Circle. Give me Chicago any day.
I taught her everything she knows.
But not about music.
It's true.
Give me the full-length overcoat, the two-button suit. Give me the Field Museum, the Art Institute.
Give me the Cubs out at Wrigley. We root, 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 and if we win, you would say they exceeded expectations.
Oh yes, go see Grand Park, that ain't no scam park. Give me Chicago, give me Chicago. Go ride the L train, now wouldn't that be swell train? Give me Chicago any day.
Now the way I'd reckon when the reckoning's done, second city is second to none. Enough chit-chatting about Manhattan.